Beneath the silent waves of the world's oceans, the United States Navy maintains one of its most powerful weapons, the nuclear-powered Virginia-class submarine. But behind this symbol of American naval dominance, a serious problem is surfacing. The Navy is struggling to build these submarines fast enough to meet growing global threats. As rival nations expand their undersea fleets, America faces a critical question: can it produce enough submarines to stay ahead in the race beneath the seas? The Virginia-class submarine represents the pinnacle of U.S. naval engineering. Stealthy, fast, and capable of striking anywhere in the world. Designed for a variety of missions, these submarines can hunt enemy vessels, launch precision Tomahawk missiles, and deploy special operations forces with unmatched secrecy. Each submarine stretches over 370 feet in length, carries a crew of around 135 sailors, and is powered by a nuclear reactor that allows it to stay submerged for months at a time. With advanced sonar systems, electronic warfare capabilities, and vertical launch tubes, it's more than a submarine. It's a moving fortress of steel and silence. Since entering service in the early 2000s, the Virginia-class has become the backbone of the U.S. Navy's undersea fleet, a critical counter to growing naval powers like China and Russia. But as the demand for these submarines rises, the U.S. shipbuilding industry is facing its toughest challenge in decades. The United States planned to produce 2 Virginia-class submarines per year, but in reality, the Navy has been struggling to deliver even 1.5. The reasons are complex: shortages of skilled workers, delays in parts and components, and the sheer complexity of building nuclear vessels. Each submarine requires millions of individual parts, thousands of welds, and coordination between hundreds of suppliers. The 2 main shipyards responsible, Electric Boat in Connecticut and Newport News Shipbuilding in Virginia, are working at maximum capacity, yet still falling behind schedule. Meanwhile, China continues to expand its own undersea fleet at a much faster pace, launching new submarines every few months. This widening production gap threatens to erode America's long-held dominance beneath the oceans. To tackle the crisis, the U.S. government has launched a massive effort to rebuild its maritime industrial base, the foundation of its naval power. A $17 billion initiative, known as the Submarine Industrial Base Expansion, aims to speed up construction by modernizing shipyards, automating production lines, and training over 10,000 new skilled shipbuilders. Shipbuilders are now adopting digital modeling, 3D printing, and AI-based quality control, transforming a centuries-old industry into a 21st-century powerhouse. The Navy also hopes to strengthen its network of suppliers, ensuring every valve, pipe, and circuit arrives on time. It's a race not just against time, but against history itself. America must rebuild the industrial muscle that once made it the world's shipbuilding superpower. But even as the Navy races to build more Virginia-class submarines, an even larger project is underway, the Columbia-class. These massive ballistic missile submarines will replace the aging Ohio-class fleet and form the core of America's nuclear deterrent for the next 40 years. The problem? Both programs, Virginia and Columbia, rely on the same workforce, the same shipyards, and the same suppliers. Every delay in one threatens the other. It's a delicate balance between maintaining today's fleet and building tomorrow's deterrent. And the stakes couldn't be higher, because under the waves, every submarine counts. Deep in the world's oceans, unseen by satellites or cameras, the silent race for undersea supremacy continues. The United States still holds the technological edge, but if production falters, that advantage could slip away. The question remains: can the U.S. Navy build fast enough to stay ahead, or will the tide of power beneath the seas begin to shift? Thank you for watching. If you enjoy exploring the hidden world of military technology and global defense, don't forget to like, subscribe, and join us for more deep dives into the future of naval warfare.